Cześć! W dzisiejszym odcinku wraz z autorem słynnej książki o włoskim futbolu, Calcio, przedstawię Wam sylwetkę sędziego, którego uważa się za najlepszego w historii. Chyba nie ma kraju, w którym sędziowie piłkarscy nie byliby krytykowani. Jednak we Włoszech arbitrom od zawsze poświęcało się jeszcze więcej uwagi niż zwykle.
What happens in Italy is that people think that the most important figure in a football game is not the forward, not the manager, not the defender, but the referee. The reason was that people blame the referee when their team loses. And therefore, when you look at, for example, TV discussions, they're mainly about the referee. They're not about the football so much, or second place. And this hatred comes from this understanding of the game through the referee as the key person in the game.
Świetnym przykładem potwierdzającym te słowa może być gra stworzona przez Enrico Prezioziego. Włoski producent zabawek dla dzieci oraz ówczesny właściciel klubu Como, a później Genoi, wprowadził do sprzedaży grę o nazwie Acchiappall'arbitro, czyli dorwać sędziego.
This is a game that was for children, allegedly, in Italy, that was made in the 1990s. I actually bought it when I was doing my research and played it, and the game was called Hit the Referee. And the game was that a light would come on and there were all these referees, plastic heads, big heads, and you would hit them. And this was sold to Italians and they got pleasure out of this game where they would hit referees on the head. And I thought this showed quite a strange attitude to this authority figure, which is someone, you know, who's just trying to referee a game of football. And Italians really hated this figure. And this game was sold to people in shops. And so I thought it revealed a lot about how Italians related to the referee. And I still have that game at home in my house.
W pewnym momencie w wyniku wielu skandalicznych decyzji oraz afer pod koniec XX wieku na Półwyspie Apenińskim krytyka wymierzona w sędziów przerodziła się w nienawiść. Dochodziło do licznych ataków na sędziów, nie tylko słownych, ale i fizycznych. Postacią, dzięki której fani futbolu we Włoszech przestali patrzeć na sędziów jak na oszustów, był Pierluigi Collina. Zapracował on na ogromne zaufanie wśród tifozich oraz przedstawicieli klubów, którzy sami prosili Federację Piłkarską o delegowanie Colliny na ich mecze.
So I think Collina is very important because he was so good at being a referee. He was better than all the others, that he kind of became something special. And the way that he made decisions, the way that he was clearly not biased, or we can come back to that, generally not seen as not biased, that meant that he kind of rose above this conflict and became this kind of figure which says, okay, if Collina's refereeing, the referee is fair. Everybody else? No. But Collina, yes. And then I think that is also shown by the fact that he internationally became very famous. He was refereed the World Cup final, the European Cup final. He became an international figure and therefore was accepted as something beyond the conflicts that were there every day. I think one of the things that he did was that he showed that he wasn't scared of the big clubs. So he wasn't scared of Juventus, which is the biggest club in Italy, the club that's always accused of buying the referees or influence the referees. And he, in some games, particularly in one game where Juventus lost the championship, he stood up to Juventus. And then lots of the other teams thought, well, this is somebody who's not biased. He's not like the others. And let's have him, because we're guaranteed to have a fair game. So I think that by standing up to the big clubs, particularly Juventus, he made himself unpopular with Juventus fans, but he made himself popular with all the other fans. So one thing is being very good, but also this standing up to power and saying, I'm just going to be fair. I'm going to play by the rules. I'm not going to be biased towards the powerful.
Collina prezentował zachowania, których wcześniej nie widziano. W roku 1997 podszedł do ławki rezerwowych i przeprosił w trakcie meczu z Juventusem trenera Interu za podjęcie błędnej decyzji, którą anulował po konsultacji z asystentem. Innym razem miał odwagę przerwać mecz z powodu obraźliwego transparentu wywieszonego na trybunach i wznowić go dopiero po tym, jak baner zdjęto. Przy innej okazji nakazał drużynom zmienić strony, by chronić jednego z bramkarzy obrzucanego z trybun różnymi przedmiotami.
Na zaufanie większości włoskich kibiców zapracował jednak w ostatniej kolejce sezonu 1999-2000.
So there's a game between Juventus and Perugia at the end of the season, and Juventus need to win the championship, and it starts raining a lot, and all the players and Perugia are winning, and all the players from Juventus want to call the game off. They say it's too wet, it's flooded, and Colina calls the game off for a little bit, and he waits and he waits, and the rain stops, and then he carries on. Juventus lose, they lose the championship. And everybody from Juventus hates him. They say, you should have called the game off, it wasn't fair. Everybody else loves him. They say, you've played by the rules, you've taken on Juventus. This game is very important because it divides people. Juventus fans, everybody else. And it shows that he will not be bent to power. So this is crucial, absolutely crucial to his reputation. And from that moment on, he's a very divisive figure. Not everybody loves him, but many people think, well, he played fair.
W tamtym momencie Colina stał się już nie tylko świetnym sędzią, ale i celebrytą. Był zapraszany do telewizji śniadaniowych, podpisywał lukratywne umowy sponsorskie, udzielał wielu wywiadów.
It's partly because of the way he looks, so completely bald, so people recognize him. Even people who didn't know about football or didn't know about Italian football, they knew that's Colina. So he was very good. He was probably the best referee, maybe the best in history. And that why he's good is an interesting question. I mean, he was very well prepared. He had very good eyesight, and he made a decision very quickly, but usually the right one. This is a very rare skill. It's almost impossible to get everything right, but he seemed to get most things right. Before VAR, before TV, yeah, which is crazy. So he's recognizable, he's very good, and he was also probably very professional, and he became in adverts and things like this. He made money from the game, and this made him different. So he started something, a kind of trend towards professionalized referees.
Wielka popularność, wysokie kontrakty, w pewnym momencie to zwróciło się przeciwko Colinie.
Latem 2005 roku słynny sędzia podpisał kontrakt z Oplem, który wówczas był także sponsorem AC Milanu. Nie spodobało się to włoskiej federacji piłkarskiej. Uznano, że może to wpłynąć na jego bezstronność. Colina został zawieszony w obowiązkach Serie A. Rozpoczął sezon prowadząc mecz trzeciej rundy Pucharu Włoch pomiędzy Pawią i Bari, podczas gdy jeszcze przed kilkoma miesiącami był rozjemcą najważniejszych spotkań na świecie.
Colina uznał, że to czas na zakończenie swojej przygody z gwizdkiem. Na specjalnie zwołanej konferencji, na której nie ukrywał żalu, ogłosił zakończenie kariery.
Although very importantly, he continued to work in training referees, in administering referees at a European, Italian and global level. So he's still part of the system and I think he's still very important in creating new referees and systems. But that was the end of his refereeing career.
A czy Pierluigi Colina może zostać nazwany najlepszym sędzią w historii?
And now I think the level is much higher. When he started, the level was very erratic. Now, I think most referees are very professional. They're trained. They watch TV all the time. They're told what to do. They have VAR. They have microphones. He didn't have any of these things. But I would like to mention another referee who's in my book, who was called Concetto Lobello, who was from Sicily, and he refereed 450 games in Serie A, and he was a legendary figure, and I think he was as good as Colina, but he refereed really in the period before TV, and I think this was a different period. TV, when you have TV, everybody is watching every second. The referee is wrong straight away. Makes a decision, 5 seconds later, everybody on Twitter, he's wrong. When Lobello was refereeing, they had TV, but there wasn't replays, there wasn't Twitter, there wasn't Facebook, there wasn't. And so it was much easier in some ways, yeah? People hated him, they shouted at him, but they didn't know he was wrong. Colina, 5 seconds later, everybody says he's wrong, which is really hard, okay? It's a hard job. So I think in the TV era, Colina is the best.
Zarówno tę historię, ale i całą masę innych historii, anegdot związanych z włoskim futbolem możecie znaleźć w książce Calcio, która dopiero niedawno została przetłumaczona na język polski. W opisie znajdziecie link, dzięki któremu będziecie mogli kupić tę książkę. Tak więc zachęcam Was, jest to naprawdę świetna rzecz, szczególnie dla fanów włoskiej piłki, ale i również fanów generalnie piłki nożnej. Tak więc zapraszam i do zobaczenia w kolejnych odcinkach.